the point of this top level site here. When I land here, all I end up doing is clicking on students. I want to see the student information. I'm a student. Show me that. Show me the student announcements. Show me the shared documents that are pertinent to students. So you might want some kind of redirect thing, and that's what I'm going to show you now. It's the redirect web part, if you can say it. So our top level site, I've got it on this page here. So I'm just going to go into edit mode. Put the page into edit mode, and then we can see that we can add some rules in here. So I can set it to a particular OU within Active Directory. I can set it to a Active Directory group, or I can set it to actual SharePoint groups. If you're a member of a particular SharePoint group, then do something. And what happens is it goes through and it goes through the different rules. As soon as it matches a rule, it will redirect you to that page. If it doesn't match any rule, it hits this last one, and you could also say, well, if no rules match anyone, I still want them to end up on a particular page. But in this example, I'm just going to do an AD group for the students page, and the redirect location is going to be our students page. So AD group is called students, and that's the location they're going to end up going to. So I'm just going to hit update. It tells me it's updated successfully. I'm just going to close the page. Now, because I'm logged in as an administrator, I can see all these locations that that people are going to go to as well. So I can see where that actually ends up. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to sign in as a student, and you're going to see me land on this page, but automatically end up on that students page. So I'm switching user from that top level site. Hit OK, and here I am on the students page. If I click back on here, I'm back on the students page. So I can't get to it. Now I can click on calendar, that still works. That still takes me to the calendar which sits at the top level. So you're not stopping people access the site, but you're saying on that page with the redirect web part, I don't want people to stay on that page. I want them to go to the relevant location, in this case, students. So I'll click on the students page, and there I am, straight away on the students page. So I can then be redirected, and that can be a SharePoint group as well, like I said, or an OU, or AD groups. And it will go through and just take the people to wherever you want. So really, really powerful, and just helps people sort of navigate around SharePoint.